All right, everyone. So I'm Smita Mishra, founder and CEO of Pandoro Technologies, and we are a platform, as Vikram mentioned, that helps enterprises identify and manage their sustainability-related risks and opportunities using the SDG framework. So I'm going to give you a quick introduction to the SDGs, a quick backdrop, and while many of you may already know what it is, we'll just take a step back, look at what SDGs are, and then take a step further and have a quick snapshot on the steps that it takes to implement it. So I'll try to keep it really brief, and I'm always to go through, so just have patience. So just a quick recap of SDGs. So especially for the investing world, and with the growing inequalities and huge population explosion that we are undergoing, world needed a plan to overcome challenges like ensuring equal access to basic amenities like clean drinking water, healthcare, education, safety, and also for protecting the biodiversity and to take concrete action against climate changes. And also another challenge that was upcoming was how can we ensure that the industrial development actually meant development for everyone? And so we needed a different kind of development, and that is where sustainable development actually started to come over. The modern concept of sustainable development is derived mostly from the 1987 Brundtland report, as per which sustainable development can be defined as a development that meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of the future generations to meet their own needs. Now, this was actually given to the world by the then chair of the World Commission of Environment and Development. She was Ms. Gro Harlem Brundtland. So the journey on sustainable development actually started in 2000 when 189 countries agreed on a vision for the new millennium. And those were called as Millennium Development Goals. And we had 8 meaningful goals there. While we made good progress on the 8 MDGs, the world was also changing fast, and we were encountering more complex problems, and we needed a new set of goals more relevant to the new world. And so in September 2015, 193 countries actually signed to work towards and meet 17 sustainable development goals by 2030. Collectively, it's called Agenda 2030, and we have about 169 targets under it and 232 indicators under it. So in short, sustainable development means that the growth must be accomplished with respect to the nature and the humankind. So sustainability sits at the intersection of the economic goals, social responsibility, and environmental protection. You might be wondering if a company can actually combine respect for environment, social equity, along with commercial success. Well, it can. And I'm going to, in fact, say that it actually helps you create value. And I'm going to give you quick examples that you can relate with. Upgrading production tools to use less energy and water is a good. It's good for the environment, but it's also good for the financial books. Offering eco-design products and packaging that use just what's necessary saves materials and shipping costs. Similarly, creating products that are accessible to the world's poorest population means opening new markets, the ones whose population is growing the fastest between now and 2050. So, as per research, about 78% of our, so these are some of the, and if you look at the right, you'll see some of the drivers of SDGs, and I'm going to mention two of them. One is, there was a research done by PwC, which says that 78% of customers are more likely to buy the goods and services of companies that have actually signed up to the SDGs. And then SDG framework also offers protection against micro risks, about operational risks, regulatory changes, and reputational risks. And we're going to talk a little bit more on micro risks in a couple of slides later, in the next slide. And according to a report by the Business and Sustainable Development Commission, the SDGs actually can generate about $12 trillion US dollars in business saving and revenue across sectors by 2030. And the report also estimates the creation of 380 million new jobs linked to these sectors in the next 10, 15 years due to alignment of business strategy to the SDGs. Overall, SDGs offer long-term direction and intentionality as opposed to the compliance-driven ESG framework.